Professor video is about how to use JASP to create a correlation matrix. Let's first open our file. It's going to be this one on caring for aged parents. And as we can see, it involves a total of 52 subjects. And a correlation matrix is going to require ratio scaling of the different variables. So let's go through as our first item of business and identify each one of the variables as being ratio scaled. Now actually many of these are just dummy coded ones and zeros, but the correlation matrix will not accept multiple nominal scaling. Okay, we go into regression, correlation matrix. Now, the default is that it is going to use Pearson coefficients and automatically report significance. Now, I think that a Spearman is a better way to go because most of these variables are really ordinal scales rather than ratio or interval. And those few ratio or interval scales that we will have will tend to be not normally distributed. So these are reasons for using the Spearman instead of the Pearson. Now, if the purpose of your correlation matrix is to identify the one variable that is the best predictor of a criterion variable, my suggestion is to put your criterion variable first or last in the variables selected. If you put it first, you'll just have to read across the top row to find the highest correlation. If you put it last, you just have to read down the far right column to find the best predictor variable. Well, in my example, let's suppose that you want to predict the subject's willingness to take an aging father. So let's put that as our first variable. Now let's take a look at the predictor variables. Whether or not the father suffers from a mental as opposed to a physical decline, whether our subject is a male, age, whether our subject is a parent, himself or herself, the relationship with the father growing up, social class, and religiosity. Now, I did not include the variables about the mother here. You will include the variables about the mother and not the variables about the father. Let's see what we have here. All we have to do is go across our top row. To make it a little bit easier to read, let's not report significance right now. Given our sample size, a correlation of about 0.27 should be statistically significant. As we go across the top row, we find that most of our correlations are quite low, starting with our experimental manipulation. It didn't make any difference whether we described the father as suffering from a mental decline or a physical decline. Didn't make much difference if the subject was male or female, the age of the subject, whether the subject was a parent, himself or herself, and social class and even religiosity were not that very important. But here is a strong correlation for one of the variables. That one variable is the quality of the relationship with the father growing up. That's the best predictor if the subject is going to be willing to take the father into his or her own home when that parent is aged. Now, just to see how significant that is, let's click on Report Significance temporarily, and we will see that it's less than 0.001. So that's how we look at the correlation matrix to identify the best predictor variable.